वेलकम गाइज, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व एग्जाम्पल नंबर 1.4 एनसीईआरटी क्लास 12 फिजिक्स. इन दिस क्वेश्चन क्वेश्चन सेज दैट देर इज इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड प्रोटोन. वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट इन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 ऑफ ए, दैट इज द रेशियो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फोर्स एंड ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एक्टिंग बिटवीन इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड अ प्रोटोन. Its charge of electron is given and mass of electron is also given. Charge of proton and charge of mass is given, and the distance between both electron and proton is not given. And in the question number 2 of A, question again says that calculate the ratio of electric force and gravitational force between two protons. There is question number B, in which we have to calculate acceleration of electron and proton, cause electron and proton both are attracting each other, therefore an acceleration will produce here. Now let's solve question number 1.4, number 1 of A. In this question, at first we will calculate electric force between electron and proton, that is according to the Coulomb's law, K Q1 Q2 upon R square. Here R is the distance between electron and proton, and it is not given, that's why we have assumed that the distance between both is R. And now the value of K is 9 into 10 to the power 9, Q1 is the charge of electron, and Q2 is the charge of proton. In this question, we will not, in this formula, we will not take the sign of charge, that is sign of electron, negative charge, because it is the scalar form of Coulomb's law, and in this formula we should not place the sign of charge. Now further it will be written as this, and finally it will comes this. Now we have to calculate gravitational force between electron and the proton, and the formula we have already studied in class 9th and class 11, that is gravitational force between two masses will be g m1 m2 by r square, where g is the universal gravitational constant. Capital G is equal to, the value of capital G is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11. m1 is the mass of electron, m2 is the mass of proton, and divided by the square of the distance. This will give the relation finally this. And now we will divide electric force and gravitational force. On dividing electric force and gravitational force, R square will be cancelled, because this is in the divide of both of the equation, electric force and gravitational force. That's why it will vanish, and now we will have this much value upon this much value. R square will be cancelled. Now after solving this, it will give the value 2.3 into 10 to the power 39 approximately. NCERT has written this 2.4 into 10 to the power 39. This will be the ratio of electric force and gravitational force between electron and a proton, separated by distance r, or called separated by some distance. Now if we will take this FG, that is gravitational force, towards this side, then electric force will be this much times of gravitational force. According to this, we can say that electric force is much greater than gravitational force. Now you can take a screenshot of this, and after that we will go to the question number 2 of A. Now we will see the question number 2 of A. In this part, there is a proton and a proton. Among them, we will calculate electric force and gravitational force again, as we have done in the previous number 1. Similarly, electric force according to Coulomb's law will be K given Q2 by R square. K is 9 into 10 to the power 9, Q1 is the charge of
proton, that is this much, and Q2 is also the charge of proton, this much. We have solved this equation in the previous part, number 1. This will be, after solving, comes out this much. Now we will calculate gravitational force between the both proton. That will be gm1 m2 by r square. G is a universal constant, 6.67 × 10⁻¹⁷. M1 is the mass of proton, first proton. M2 is the mass of second proton, and the distance between them is not given. That's why it is assumed that is r square. After solving this, this will be come to this much, and now we will divide electric force and gravitational force, which we have to calculate. This value electric force and this value gravitational force, this r square and r square will be cancelled, that's why the result will come out this much, and after solving this value we will get this much, that is electric force by gravitational force will be the ratio this much. Please take the screenshot, and now we will go to the next part of the question, that is number B. We have to calculate in the acceleration of electron and proton, both are given at some distance.
Now this is the 1.4 question part B. In this question, there is an electron and a proton. Among them only, the question is saying that assume only the electric force acting between these two, electron and proton, and neglect the gravitational force. Now solve, now calculate the force, and finally evaluate the value of acceleration produced in electron and the proton. Now electron is the negative charge and proton is the positive charge, therefore both will attract into each other, therefore electron will move towards this side and proton will move towards this side. Now at first we will calculate electric force between them, and the distance between them is 1 angstrom, that is 10⁻¹⁰ meter. Now electric force is kq1q2/r² according to Coulomb's law. In this formula we will not take the sign of charge, this is the scalar form of Coulomb's law, that's why k, the value of k is 9×10⁹, q1 is 1.689, q2 is this much, the proton have also the same charge, and the distance between them the square of the distance. After solving this step by step, we will get the value this much, and a point will be put here, and this will be this much. This is the electric force acting on electron and proton both. According to the Newton's third law, the electric force exerted on proton due to electron and the electric force on electron due to proton, both will be same and in the opposite direction. Force on electron will be along this side, and the force on proton will be along this side, and the value of both will be same, that is this much. For and now we will calculate the acceleration for electron. We can say that acceleration is equal to force divided by mass. According to the Newton's second law, we know that F barabar ma, therefore A is equal to F by m. Acceleration is equal to force divided by mass of the electron. So then this is the acceleration, force on electron divided by mass of electron, this is, and after solving that, this will be the value of acceleration produced in the electron. Now we will calculate the acceleration in the proton. This will be the again electric force divided by mass of the proton. Electric force is the value this much, and the mass of the proton is given in the NCRT. After solving this, it will be the acceleration of the proton. Now you can take the screenshot. Okay, if you are new to our channel, please subscribe and like the video. Thank you so much. Bye bye.